Hi all. Today we'll see the DC generator's voltage equation. This is E. Manjula, lecturer in electrical from GIVU Secunderabad. Recap. In the previous period, we have discussed about the types of DC generator and DC generator different parts, classifications of a DC generator based on excitation, and types of the winding of a DC generator. Okay. On completion of this topic, you would be able to know the different types of DC generator connections and voltages and current equations for different types of DC generator. We have already seen the classifications of the DC generator. Again, we'll review it. So, according to the excitations, the classifications of the DC generators are classified. There is a separately excited generator and self-excited generator. In self-excited, shunt type generator, series type generator, and compound type generator. In compound type, again two types are there, that is long shunt and short shunt compound. So the voltage drops in a DC generator. So we'll see what are the voltage, different voltage drops are available in a DC generator. In any electrical circuit, voltage drop occurs in series elements only. Remember this, the voltage drop occurs only in a series elements. In DC generator, voltage drop occurs in series elements only. So what are the series elements which are available in a DC generator? That is armature, brushes, series field and load. These are the different series elements which are available in a DC generator. So we'll see the armature voltage drop. What is an armature voltage drop? When armature current IA flows through the armature winding, having a resistance RA, some voltage drop occurs in an armature winding. That is, the armature voltage drop is equals to armature current into armature resistance. That is, IA into RA. So VA is equals to IA into RA. So the next is a series field voltage drop. So what is a series field voltage drop? When a series field current ISC flows through the series field winding RSC, series field drop occurs in the series field winding. So series field drop is equals to series field current into series field resistance. That is, VSC is equals to ISC into RSC. Then the next drop is brush contact voltage drop. It is the voltage drop due to brush contact resistance. So, this voltage drop is due to the brush contact resistance. So brush contact drop depends on, first one is value of contact resistance, how much the contact resistance it has, and the amount of armature current. But brush contact voltage drop is considered as constant for all loads. Remember this, the brush contact voltage drop, it is considered as contact for all other loads. Okay. Brush contact for different materials. So the brush contact voltage drops are different with the different materials. For metal, graphite brushes, it is 0.5 volts. And for carbon brushes, it is 2 volts. So whenever we use a graphite brush, it is considered that it is a voltage constant voltage drop at brush. that if it is a graphite, it is 0.5 volts. If the material is chosen for carbon, then it is 2 volts. Fine, this is a shunt generator. So we know Z and ZZ is a field, A and AA is an armature, and this is a load. As this is a generator, the current will come out of the armature. It is showing the direction this, and here it is divided, the current. Some of the current will flow through the load, that is IL, and the current which is flowing through the field, that is called ISH. As this is a shunt field, it is an ISH. So we'll see the equations now. The field winding connected in parallel to the armature. Yes, you'll be able to see it. So ISH here, ISH is equals to V divided by RSH. So here the resistance is RSH, which is not mentioned, and here the resistance will be RA, that is the armature resistance. So according to the circuit diagram, we can write IA is equals to ISH plus IL. Then EG, if we apply the Kirchhoff laws, EG is equals to V plus IARA plus BCD, that is brush contact voltage drop. Brush contact drop, BCD. Okay. So this is about the shunt generator. So we'll see, coming to the series generator. Series generator, here the series field winding is connected in series to the armature. Okay, at armature we will have the internal resistance RA, that is the armature resistance, and the series resistance is RSC. And here the current, this current is IA, and this is ISC, this is I. So all the currents are equal here. So the field winding is connected in series with the armature. Yes. And yes, there will be a difference in the field winding. If this is a series winding construction is in such, it is in that way that the material conductor, the cross-sectional area of the series field winding will be very large, and the length of the series field winding will be short. And when compared to the shunt field winding, go to back. Here in shunt field winding, this winding will be very long winding and with a thin cross-sectional area when compared to the series field winding. Because of this change, this winding will have RSH, the value will be very high, that is like 100 ohms and 250 ohms. Whereas a series field winding, it has RSC is equals to 0.2 ohms, 0.5 ohms. It is very less than 10 ohms, the value of the series winding will be. Okay, so here all the currents are in series. So IA is equals to armature current is equals to series current, which is also equal to the load current. All the currents are equal here. And EG, the generated voltage EMF, which is equals to V plus IARA here plus ISCRSC plus the brush contact, that is BCD. So here already we know that IA and ISC both are equal. So taking it as common as I. So EG is equals to V plus I into RA plus RSC plus BCD. Okay. So this is about the series generator voltage generating EMF. And the compound, coming to the compound generator, the first one is a long type of long shunt compound generator. There are two types in a compound generator, already we know it. The first one is a long shunt and the second one is a short shunt. Here the name it is because the shunt field winding which is connected across the armature and the series field winding is showing it as long. See if here it is a long shunt compound, here what it is means like this shunt field winding is connected across the load, total load, or I can say that it is connected across the series field and also the armature. So this is a long shunt compound. We can observe the differences when we go to the short shunt compound. Here the armature current which is coming out from the armature, and this is an ISC current, and here IA and ISC both are in series. So IA is equals to ISC in the long shunt, and here IA or ISC will divide into two parts, that is ISH and IL. And the internal resistance of the series field is RSC, internal resistance of shunt field is RSH, and the internal resistance of armature is RA. So both the series and shunt windings are present here. So it is called compound. It is a compound generator is a combination of shunt and series winding. So ISH is equals to here if you see ISH is equals to as it, this is parallel to the voltage. So V, so ISH is equals to V divided by RSH. IA which is equals to IL plus ISH IA. So EG is equals to after applying Kirchhoff voltage law, we can say that EG is equals to V plus IA RA plus ISC RSC plus BCD. So we already know that IA is equals to ISC as these both are in series. So I'm taking it as common IA. So V plus IA into RA plus RSC plus brush contact drop. So this is the voltage drop of the long shunt compound generator. We'll see the voltage generated in a short shunt compound. Okay. Coming to the short shunt compound generator, see here if we observe the differences between the long shunt and short shunt. Here, the name itself is indicating it is a short shunt. The shunt is connected only across the armature. Hence, it is called short shunt compound generator. So here, the armature current is divided to the shunt field winding and also to the series field winding. And the series field current is directly going to the load. So ISC is equals to IL here. Both the series and shunt field winding are present because it is a compound generator. And here VSH is equals to, that is the voltage across the shunt is equals to V plus ISC RSC. The drop across this, the voltage VSH here is equals to V plus ISC RSC. And IA is equals to ISC plus ISH. Sorry, this is ISH ma'am. One is ISC and ISH. And we know that ISC is equals to IL. So ISH is equals to VSH divided by RSH. So ISH is equals to VSH divided by RSH. But we know that VSH is equals to V plus ISC RSC. So substituted V plus ISC RSC. So the total energy EMF, sorry, EMF generated, which is equals to VSH here VSH plus ISC RSC so we can say even like this that V EG is equals to V this V plus ISC RSC plus IARA प्लस बीसीडी। सो so this is not vs chama, this is v, only v. Okay, and here one more thing is this is ish. Okay, so you should remember the difference. See, if you go for short shunt again, long shunt again, in the long shunt that v plus ia and rsc both are same, so we took common here, but whereas in long shunt, short shunt, that is the difference. You need to identify the difference that both are different currents now. Ia is different and Isc is different. So we kept like that only. Okay. So here finally we discussed about the different types of a DC generator and the voltage and current equations of a DC current. So hope this session is understood to everybody. Thank you.